What are some of the things to consider when hiring an immigration lawyer? What makes a great immigration lawyer? Today, I'm here with Steve Maggi, founding partner of SMALawyers.com. Steve, let's talk about that a little bit. You're an immigrant yourself. You come from another country. Why is that important? What perspective does that bring when you're serving your clients as an immigration lawyer, understanding that process?
Yeah, I think that you could attest to this too, Domenic. It's important to empathize with clients. So I have the luxury of having been a business attorney and working with a lot of business and investment-based visa work, which gives me the expertise on a legal and practical level. But it's also important to care enough to take that extra step and to say, I know where you've been, I'm an entrepreneur, I'm from another country, and I want to make sure that this goes correctly. And you hope that the client will collaborate with you and take your lead and follow and do the things that you ask. Remember, you asked about problems with petitions. A lot of those come when the client does not listen or does it how they think it should be done, as opposed to listening to us as the expert. So I think that the empathy part is the last ingredient that really makes it viable.
What are some of the more common errors that you've seen on some of these applications, on the E2s and the L1s?
I think it's really not following the lead of the attorney. And that's me specifically in this case, because I have seen from the cases that were previously denied that were presented by other attorneys what should not be done. And an attorney who's experienced, an immigration one who's effective, will always be changing the way that they present cases based on new requests for evidence, new requests from the embassies and consulates. What are the new wrinkles? How is the law being interpreted differently? It's not just black or white. It changes depending who the consular officer is, who the immigration officer is. What are the trends that are coming along that can lead to denials if you don't modify? So if you work with a firm that just plugs in into a formula and uses templates, and they're not modifying every day how they do the cases and emphasizing the strengths and doing what I call preemptive strikes, which is anticipating what could be asked for, what problems could be cited by immigration, then that's when you're successful. So that's part of planning. And so a lot of the cases we do, E2s and L1s, we spend 6 months preparing them so they're on point and they're up to speed in terms of what the new changes and new wrinkles are. And I think that's really important.
So let's talk about what makes a great immigration lawyer for an entrepreneur or for a business. You spoke earlier about empathy being very important. You spoke about preparation and keeping up to date with current trends. Steve, what are some of the more important things that people should consider when evaluating a business immigration lawyer?
Well, I think the first one is experience. And it's important to note that E2 visas, for example, are submitted at the U.S. embassies and consulates around the world, and that each embassy and consulate is its own island. So the law is the same, but the way that the law is applied and the points that are emphasized by those specific E2 groups that are evaluating those petitions really differs based on what embassy or consulate you apply. It could be London does it one way and Istanbul does it a different way. And if the attorney doesn't know specifically what the people in that embassy or consulate are looking for, how to present it correctly, knowing really what the tendencies are in terms of minimum investment or specific documents that they want to see, then you're not going to be presenting the case as effectively as possible and you could be denied. I just recently had a case in Tokyo that I picked up that was previously denied, and it was presented as if it were a case presented here in the United States with the wrong evidence, the wrong emphasis, the wrong information, and we just got it approved for these two individuals that are running a steak restaurant in New York. So you have to, your knowledge is micro knowledge. It's really boils down even to the specific embassy or consulate. So it's not just knowing what the law says and having a formulaic exhibit list and process. It has to be adapted for each case. So I guess that leads into the second thing, which is being up to speed on changes, tendencies, the way that each embassy, consulate, or immigration service in the United States is adjudicating these cases. That also changes depending on which service center in the United States is adjudicating a case, Vermont, Texas, California. They all have different points of emphasis. They all have different things that they focus on. And if you want to minimize roadblocks and do preemptive strikes and present a strong case up front, you have to be familiar. This is a very intimate knowledge that someone needs to have. And there are very few immigration lawyers that can tell you how different embassies and consulates work. They may just have a template that they plug in. And that will not work in this day and age.
You're a business owner yourself. founder of SMA Law. What perspective do you think that gives you when representing other entrepreneurs and business owners?
Well, the thing I love most about my job, and I think you would agree with this, is it's infectious. There's this passion that comes across from every new startup. So a lot of these individuals I meet when I speak overseas, they have these wonderful ideas. They may have capital, and they have an overabundance of enthusiasm. And so I'm injected with that enthusiasm every time I work on a new case. It's like when I first launched my firm overseas and said, I'm gonna hang my own shingle and just try and see, make this work. And then I meet similar like-minded people I've helped people from about 75 different countries. So every walk of life, every culture, every continent, but we share that common enthusiasm for entrepreneurship and the American dream, believing in it as an immigrant, knowing that if you work really hard and have a vision, you can help other people or you can be successful. My vision happens to be to help other people similar to me, even though I can't comprehend even the high-tech things that they're doing in many of these cases, which are tech or fintech or medtech. It's just so infectious to work with them. So I think that empathy and enthusiasm and having a common shared interest, meaning I'm also invested in the case. Because if I help a company, let's say like Joe in the Juice, which is one of my clients, launch in the US, and then I see 50 stores pop up and I see 500 jobs created.
Wow, that must feel very rewarding.
It's incredibly rewarding. I walked by one of the shops today coming to meet with you, Domenic, and I thought, this might not be here and those people might not be working right now if I hadn't come up with a strategy to bring the managers and executives here that was effective and then allowed them for 3 years to bring all their managers in without having to apply in the United States for any more petitions, to submit any more petitions. So that I think is the most important thing. It's not just the legal knowledge, which is so important and keeping up on tendencies, but the passion and empathy that you need.
Steve, there's some young people watching this video right now. Students, law students. What's it like to be an immigration lawyer? What do you love about your job?
Well, I have to admit that I was a corporate and finance attorney. I did that for 2 years at a big law firm, and that is for some people. But what I realized was, even though it gave me a good base of knowledge that I use for my business-based cases now, that wasn't what I was passionate about. What I was passionate about was connecting with other immigrants and in all their iterations and working with sophisticated cases and simple cases. So my recommendation always is to find that passion. And if your gut says, this is not for me, then you try to steer the course in a different direction. Don't get stuck in a job for 20 years that you're not passionate about. And I just happened to find that because that's part of my ethos. That's who I am. I'm an entrepreneur and an immigrant. And I love the sophisticated, complicated cases because I have the backing and the experience for that. But I also love the simple ones too because they all add something positive to the cultural fabric here in the economy.
Steve, what makes you feel good at work?
When I take on a very difficult case and on its face, it looks like there's really no way this will go through. And then you're sitting there and you're coming up with strategies and arguments and you have that light bulb moment of how to tie it all together and essentially convince a consular officer or an immigration officer in the US that wants to deny a case that they actually should approve it. And then you get the approval notice. That to me is the most satisfying moment. And then you know that people will be moving to the US or remaining in the US because of what you did, specifically what efforts you made.
You have an impact on people's future and people's lives and where they get to live.
Absolutely, that changes the course of their futures and also all the jobs that are created by the companies that I help. I work with business lawyers like yourself and other specialized attorneys. And we come up with a strategy and we form a company and we set up all the documents and we strategize maybe a year in advance. And then one day you get a call from somebody comes out of the consulate in Amsterdam and says, I have my visa and I'm coming with my kids. Let's have coffee next week. And it's incredibly satisfying.
You get to meet the family and see the impact you've made.
Yeah, and you become part of this bigger and bigger family in these communities where you're helping more and more businesses and individuals.
Steve, this has been very informative. Thank you so much for joining us. How can people contact you?
They can go on our website, smalawyers, with an s.com, or they can just email me at smaggi@smalawyers.com.
And Steve, if someone has an immediate need, can they also call you?
Absolutely. Our office number is 212-402-6885.
Thanks so much, Steve. We've been speaking with immigration lawyer Steve Maggi. of smalawyers.com. Very experienced immigration lawyer.
Thank you so much, Domenic.